What they're thinking is totally irrelevant to a normal person's thoughts.
It's what's known as the Gothic movement, violent and black.
Black relates to the dark side, so Gothics usually dress in all black. They a lot of times put white makeup on their face to appear dead.
A growing and to many troubling trend in suburban America.
In the Gothic movement, they have what's called the blood sports, where they're involved in self-mutilation in some cases. A lot of young females particularly slice themselves with razor blades. And don't ask me to explain that because I can't. I mean, I know that they're mixed up kids.
And for the last 7 years, Steve Bricker, Denver Police Department gang leader, has been trying to spread the word about the so-called Gothic movement. Has helped fuel a new kind of teenage gang, white suburban gang, built around a fascination with the grotesque and with death, for members of the so-called trench coat mafia, for whom the black coats are what colors are for the Bloods and the Crips of the big city.
Boys may have been part of a dark underground national phenomenon known as the Gothic movement, and that some of these goths may have killed before. Son David and his girlfriend were convicted on charges of attempted murder. They were proud, self-proclaimed members of the Gothic movement, like the students involved in yesterday's shooting.
there have been a series of violent episodes around the country linked to teenagers who called themselves goths. Just last November in Burlington, Wisconsin, police say five students with ties to a so-called goth group had planned to storm their high school heavily armed, take the principal hostage, and kill student and faculty targets.
The boys may have been part of a dark underground national phenomenon known as the Gothic Movement, and that some of these goths may have killed before.
Anybody who would get in their way, I think they potentially would kill.